as I lay me down. Heaven, hear me now. I'm lost without a cause. After giving it my all, winter storms have come and darkened my sun. After all that I've been through, who on earth can I turn to? I look to you. I look to you. After all my strength is gone, in you I can be strong. I look to you. Searching for that open door. And every road that I've taken led to my regret. And I don't know if I'm gonna make it. Nothing to do but lift my head. I look to you. I look to you.
Too many to take. times seven, you've forgiven me. Crucified, yet you prayed to your Father to forgive us. We caused you pain time and again. Still you laid down your life because you guilty then, here I am again. Against you only have I sinned. Change me now, never let my heart grow cold. Change me somehow, purify this needy soul. Look into my heart, tell me what you see. Cleanse me when you find any wicked way in me. With your tender touch, Lord, I need you so to change me now.
kindly stand with me as we begin by singing, "Every Praise is to Our God."
Father in heaven, we bless you this evening and we honor you because you are a faithful God. Father, no matter what situation we are going through, we could always turn to you and trust in you. And Father, this occasion this evening is a sorrowful but yet a joyful occasion. For we know that our sister is with you, Lord God. But we here on earth, we are in grieving, God. So, Father, this evening, I ask that the Comforter will come alongside every family member here this evening. That your peace would reside with them, God. Father, and in times when tears may come, God, I ask you in the name of Jesus that you will cause them to look up to you, God. Because you are the author and the finisher of their faith. So, Father, this evening, I turn this service over to you, God. Take complete control. And we say thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Kindly take your seats. We'll now have our first scripture reading, and it is taken from Psalm 23. It will be read by Mrs. Judy Bishop.
Good evening. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen. We'll now have a tribute from the TPC Women's Chorus, which our sister was a member of. This will be read by Auntie Jean.
Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ. Sister Clarissa was a person of quiet nature. Reflecting on her life for the short time we were with her, we can boldly say that she was a godly woman, loving, independent, were some of the characteristics she displayed. Sister Clarissa joined the ministry of the Women's Chorus and was very dedicated to this ministry because she loved singing. She was so happy among us and the fellow believers to be a part of this that to the extent that for practice sessions, which commence at 5, Sister Clarissa will be here at 4, making sure she was on time for each session. She always carried a smile which captivated us. And that smile became broader when she greeted our choir director, Mrs. Angela Christie. She loved Mrs. Christie. She traveled often, but as soon as she returned, rest assured, she eagerly rejoined us in ministry, not only joining us, but requesting all of the music she would have missed. Our sister loved worshiping with fellow believers and always had a word of God for you. Make a joyful noise in Psalm 122, verse 1, and Psalm 100, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. She would say that to us and smile. I can sing. And I was glad when they said unto me, come into the house of the Lord. On more than one occasion, she said that to me. Today, sister, I stand here and take pleasure in sharing this short tribute on behalf of the Women's Chorus, who are seated to my left, some of them due to COVID instructions. We will always miss her, and we pray that her strength and her disposition will be remembered by you, her family, and friends for a long time. At this time, Sister Deborah Boyce will render a song, Give Me Jesus. When this song was introduced to us, Mrs. Christie was told by Sister Clarissa, when I die, sing that for me. That's my favorite song. So Sister Deborah will now render that song on her behalf.
In the morning, when I rise, in the morning, when I rise, in the morning, when I rise, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. give me Jesus, you can have all this world. Give me Jesus. When I am alone, oh, when I am alone, oh, when I am alone, give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can have all this world. Give me Jesus. Come to die, when I come to die, oh, when I come to die, just give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, you can have all this world. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can have all this world. You can have all this world. You can have all this world. Give me Jesus. We'll have our second scripture reading, Psalm 100, and this will be read by Miss Beverly Bourne. Browner, sorry.
Joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye land. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his grace with thanksgiving, and into his court with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is God, he is mercy in everlasting, and his truth endures to all generation. Give my aunt Jesus as she said, and she shall have him. Thank you.
Stand with me again as we sing The Goodness of God.
The
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my life I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest nights, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the good of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Seated. At this time, we'll have the tributes. This will be followed in song by Libby L. Aline, a tribute in song.
Good afternoon. For some people, it's afternoon, and some people, it's good evening, but mothers are God's gift to the world, and it is with good pleasure that I recognize a woman who was called Mama Clarice and Smithy. My mother did all she could for us as children. Growing up in Barbados was very tough, especially when you are raised in a very poor condition. What I admire about my mom is the great focus that she exhibited around us. Mama worked for the National Conservation Commission, and I could remember her taking us to the beaches and the other areas. that she worked, Mama would wake up every morning, or many mornings actually, and cook food for us and leave it for us to eat, especially when we were on vacation. As far as I could remember, she would always be working on some project, whether it was making wall ornaments, working as an Amway Stanley representative, and making our clothes. Mama would try many things to make our lives as comfortable as possible. Mind you, Mama had many pressures. She only worked for sometimes $30 to $50 a week. And I saw the fear sometimes in her eyes when the bills were due. She decided to do whatever was necessary to ensure that we had electricity and means to get to school. She was very strict. And since she had four girls, you can imagine what our growing up was like. I do reflect on many days before leaving home. Mama would do a visual inspection of what I wore. And if, according to her standards, that I wore was too revealing, she would demand that you take off or remove every piece of clothing before you step through the door. Mama gave me the drive to strive towards success and never to back down when it came to a difficult, challenging task. I saw her work her way from poverty to a place of comfort. I said comfort because Mama was never one who looked at things to make her the woman she became. Mama would find animals, stray dogs and cats, and feed them and make sure that they recover. She spent her time nursing people back to health and praying for them. Mama loved church going, loved to sing, and always wanted to serve others. Traveling was what she enjoyed, and once she landed in Barbados from a trip to Anne, Sharon, and myself, guaranteed before the plane landed back in Barbados, she was planning her next trip. It gives me great pleasure to announce that today I celebrate Mama's life as one that was very carefree in her later years. I was given a gift that I do cherish today. And to you, I pass this gift on to you that was given to me by her. She offered me salvation. No matter your circumstance, your level of education, the many accolades you have, the money you have, and the social status, what you have done for Jesus Christ will only last.
I'm the youngest of the four girls, probably the most problematic. I'm sure my sisters would say that. Let me tell you a little bit about my mom, and I'll share with you more on the creative side, something that I myself have taken after. I remember as a young girl, her and my Aunt Eve would actually be smocking pieces of material that will later be used to make dresses to be sold to the tourists coming off the ships. From there, I also recall her using, I don't even know if the term is still being used here, but she would use pipe cleaners and bits of plastic and paper to make floral arrangements. And by the time she was through, it basically reminded me of what our hibiscus garden out front had looked like. That was not enough for her because that creative bug kept biting her and she just kept going and kept going. I recall the days of her having these centerpieces made out of sponge. You had a little doll in the center. I don't know if any of you would remember them, but you had these slender dolls in the center, and it's similar to a Barbie doll, but it's no, it wasn't a Barbie doll. Might have been Barbie's cousin, 2, 3, maybe 12 times removed, but most definitely not Barbie. We couldn't afford that. But the dress, the ball gown that the doll would have around it is made out of sponge and pins. I'm getting the nod in the audience, and stencils. And you wouldn't think that you can make such a beautiful center arrangement with just those simple pieces. That still was not enough for Mom. I remember her using straw and weaving straw to make baskets, to make hats, to make coasters, and to make table mats. And I remember the day being so excited when we were sitting out on the step, and she's weaving away, and she gives me a piece of straw, and of course, as usual, I'm full of myself, thinking I'm all that, because I got a piece of straw, so I can weave too. Mind you, no instruction, but I'm weaving. I can look across and I can tell you what she's making. You can see the project and you can tell whether it's a table mat, a coaster, a hat. And you can look at my project and I'll chalk it up to abstract art. But the thing that I will leave with you today is this. She never limited herself. It was never a matter of her deciding that she just wanted to do this one thing and she got stuck in that box. And I think because of that imagination she had and that willingness to allow herself to dream, to go beyond the shores of this beautiful island, I think some of that tenaciousness and some of that ability that she had to stick to a project and to finish it, that is one of the things that I will say that she has definitely passed on to her daughters, which has allowed us to be successful in our own rights. And I say to you, for your kids, for you yourselves, in as much as you may not have a lot today, that means absolutely nothing. We came from very, very little. 4 in a bed, asleep at night, to us having our own homes. Now, I'm gonna say to you, allow your kids to dream, because that is the thing that is gonna help them to be their better selves.
Good evening. In life, we prepare for delivery of a baby with excitement and numerous other occasions with joy. But no one prepares for death this way. There is no packing of bags, shining of shoes for this thing called death. The truth is, death happens to all of us at some point. One truth is that while living, we ought to live for Christ and live our best lives through Him. My mother, known as Mama, lived her best life. On July 24, 2021, heaven's gates were wide open, and with a smile, she opened her lush white feathered angel wings freely and spread them wider than the vast seas. Then soared high through those pearly gates to meet our Savior Jesus Christ. Even though I miss her, I know that she's in a better place where she would never be afraid or sad or unhappy. She's finally in a place where only joy abounds. Let me tell you a little about my mom. She glowed from inside out with a smile whenever I saw her. And in my growing up years, she showed kindness to others. For example, I know of times that she cooked food and shared it with the less fortunate here in Barbados. She also washed clothing for them in her free time. No matter who was coming to visit, she always cooked a large pot of food. No one went hungry. Her kindness extended to the homeless and less fortunate when she assisted at a local church in New York food bank. In this charity, she handed out food to them. She has said that it made her feel good helping others. My mother's kindness and giving of her time was also shown when she sang in the church choir of People's Cathedral. She told me that I love to sing and praise the Lord, and expressed frequently that she loved her church choir. She said that it was her way of witnessing to others in song. Additionally, being a People's Cathedral church host was a way for her to greet people with a smile and make them feel good with small conversation. Mama loved all four of us girls, Judy, Rosemary, Anne, and me. She showed care for us the best way she could. She struggled to provide for us when we were children, and in the end, it paid off. I'm proud to say that she has raised four beautiful, willful, and ambitious women. It is a testament of taking example from her as a mother, through her resilience, no matter what came her way. She was a mother, a servant of God, a grandmother, a friend, and a companion. Her favorite thing was dressing up. She loved to have everything tucked in, every strand of hair in place, and her makeup was just right. She really enjoyed traveling to various places in the USA to visit Rosemary, Anne, and myself. It became her passion. Judy remembers her favorite line, "Take it easy and relax." It showcased her tender side. Losing a mother brings grief that cuts so deep, so much that words cannot explain. It really has taught me that I am human, because I realize sadness with her passing to heaven. Although this sorrow is here, there is truth that never fades away, like sorrow does. And that truth is that heaven is real, and Mama made it to its gates, and she's saying, "Don't cry for me, because we will meet again."
That's great. Okay.
Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. I've been set free. No need to fear, God spoke to me, my time had come. He made a way to bring me home. Don't cry for me, my pain is gone forever. Don't cry for me, my body's been made whole. Don't cry for me, we'll soon be back together. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul. I saw the light, I took his hand. We flew on high to the promised land. My soul lives on in a better place, with all his glory, with all his grace. Don't cry for me, my pain is gone forever. Don't cry for me, my body's been made whole. Don't cry for me, we'll soon be back together. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul. My pain is gone, please understand. My passing was in God's great plan. I'm with you still, each day and night. Just close your eyes, I'll hold you tight. Don't cry for me, my pain is gone forever. Don't cry for me, my body's been made whole. Don't cry for me, we'll soon be back together. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul. I'm in your heart, I feel your pain. Don't give up hope, our love remains. I'll wait for you at heaven's door. We'll meet again one day for sure. Don't cry for me, my pain is gone forever. Don't cry for me, my body's been made whole. Don't cry for me, we'll soon be back together. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul. Don't cry for me, don't shed a tear. I've been set free, no need to fear. Don't cry for me, my pain is gone forever. Don't cry for me, my body's been made whole. Don't cry for me, we'll soon be back together. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul. Don't cry for me, I'm well within my soul.
Praise the Lord. I'm sure those words that were just sung have brought comfort to the loved ones of our deceased sister. Some of the words says that it is well within her soul. And we believe this evening that Sister Clarissa, being absent from the body, is present with the Lord, because it is well, it was well with her soul, and she lived with that confidence and that blessed hope and assurance that she would see her Savior one day. Passing of a mother, a loved one, is never easy, but we know that God's will must be done, and we trust him, his guidance, his faithfulness. We trust that he is all-knowing, he's all-powerful, he is all-wise. And when we cannot understand, we must trust his grace to undergird us and to strengthen us in such times. So on behalf of our Pastor Rosie Williams and our senior pastor, Pastor Joel Callender, the board, the elders, the members of the People's Cathedral, we want to extend our deepest condolences to our Sister Clarissa's family, her children, and her loved ones, and to assure you of our prayers, as we have been doing. We will continue to remember you in prayer, that God will strengthen you. Our Sister Clarissa was a member of this church for 32 years, and we know that she has been faithful to her God, and she has seen to it that all her children have grown up in the faith of the Lord. And for this, we give God thanks, and we give God praise as we come to celebrate her life this evening. It's a service of thanksgiving, service of celebration for the life she has lived. Truly, she will be missed, but we have the confidence and the assurance that she is in a better place. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you this evening, because even in the midst of our sorrow and grief, we can rejoice knowing that our sister Clarissa is at home with you. We thank you for that assurance. We thank you, Lord, for that confidence that we have. And we pray, God, that the word that will be shared today will be a source of strength, encouragement, and a challenge to those who do not know Jesus as Savior. So we ask your anointing upon this word in the name of Jesus. Amen. Proverbs chapter 14 and verse 32 says, "The wicked is driven away in his wickedness, but the righteous has hope in his death." The righteous has hope in his death. In 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 19, the Apostle Paul said, "If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. But we are glad today that even in the midst of death, we can have hope." Death is something that brings sorrow and it brings separation, it brings grief. But for the believer, we can have hope in death. The word says the righteous has hope in his death. Children of God have a glorious hope of life beyond the grave in the presence of him who said, "I am the resurrection and the life. He that believe on me, though he were dead, yet shall he live." And life on earth is a pilgrimage, a journey that we must all make from this earth. Our destination is either heaven or hell. It depends on what preparations you have made here. And your preparations in this life will determine where you will spend eternity. For we are pilgrims passing through this life. Some 70, 80, 90 years or more, and some less. But whether we go by death or by the rapture, we must all leave this world at some point. It is something that we must all give serious consideration to. For the word tells us that it is appointed unto man once to die, but after that, the judgment. The person who has a relationship with the Lord Jesus in this life through accepting him as their own personal Savior is not troubled by the thought of leaving this world. They know, according to the word of God, that there is stored up for them so much more than this world could ever offer. The Apostle Paul tells us in 1 Corinthians 2:9 that "I have not seen, nor ear heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for them that love him." And 2 Corinthians 5:1 tells us, "For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens." Jesus himself said in John 13:2, "In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you." And the place that Christ has prepared for us would be far better than anything that we could ever have or imagine in this life. I believe that such precious promises must have inspired the songwriter to write, "What a day that will be, when my Jesus I shall see. When I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand, leads me through the promised land, what a glorious day that will be." And our sister Clarissa experienced that day when she passed from life into eternity. But death is not the end. It was just a gateway for her to experience the fullness of all that her God has created for her and that Jesus purchased for her at Calvary. Believers keep their eyes on the goal and the rewards that await us. 1 John 3, 1-3 says, "Now are we the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know, that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And every man that hath this hope in him purifieth himself, even as he is pure." To realize that our ultimate goal and destination is heaven. That's our goal. That's our destiny. To see our Savior, to inherit and enjoy all that he has prepared for us. Then the most urgent thing in this life is to purify ourselves. Keep ourselves pure that we may inherit the blessings of eternity. For no sin shall enter heaven. We have a blessed hope. The believer in Christ looks forward to that day where they will see their Savior. Our sister Clarissa looked forward to that day when she would see Jesus. It is the blessed hope of the believer. And all the attractions and interests, all of this world's glitter, and what it has to offer become insignificant when we compare it to our final destiny and what awaits us. It's more than we can ever imagine or think, according to the Word of God. In life, we prepare for great events. We prepare for weddings. We prepare for births. We prepare for various festivals. And those particular events that we prepare for become the center of our focus. And everything else becomes insignificant because we are focused on those occasions for which we are preparing. The anticipation of these things will dominate our lives as we prepare for them and wait for them to take place. Even so, the word says, every man that hath this hope in him purifies himself even as he is pure. As we prepare for eternity, as we wait for the coming of Christ, as we wait to behold him, that should take precedence in our lives. Many years ago, our sister began her preparation for that day when she would meet her Savior. She prepared by receiving Christ as her personal Lord and her Savior. She prepared by following him in the waters of baptism and being a testimony and a witness. She continued in preparation by faithful church attendance, by prayer, by studying the Word of God, by partaking of the Lord's Supper, hearing God's Word and fellowshipping with the believers, and her ministry to the Lord in the women's chorus were the most important things in her life. She prepared for eternity. She prepared by giving her life completely to Christ. Why? Because she recognized that she was only on a pilgrimage, and one day that pilgrimage will come to an end. She was not rich in this world's goods, but she was rich in faith and love for the Lord Jesus. You heard her daughters testified of coming from a poor background. They didn't have much, but their mom had Jesus, had a faith that was anchored in God, and that was the most important thing in her life. She was rich in faith and love for the Lord Jesus, and as such, she left a legacy for them. Not of money, not of riches, not of material things, but of a faith anchored in the Lord Jesus. A faith that would take them through the storms of life and help them to meet the challenges with which they are faced from day to day. On our pilgrimage through this life, we will face many obstacles. Life is not a bed of roses. The Christian life is not easy. There's a real enemy who will unleash his attacks on us in an effort to cause us to turn aside and hinder us from reaching our goal and receiving our rewards. He has been successful in the lives of some people, sad to say. For many of those who once traveled on this pilgrim journey with us, but they have turned back. Some have been discouraged. Some doubted and dropped out of the race. I'm sure that many times our sister Clarissa felt the attacks of the enemy, but she remained steadfast in keeping her eyes focused on Jesus, the author and the finisher of her faith. She knew in whom she believed, and she was persuaded that he would keep her until this day. In so doing, she made it to the finishing line, and consequently, like Paul, she could say, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but to all them who love his appearing. For us to be successful on this journey and make it to the end, we must be strong to withstand all the attacks of the enemy. We are glad this evening that we do not have to make this journey by ourselves, but we have been given help in the person of the Holy Spirit, who comes alongside of us and gives us the strength to go on. When we feel like giving up, when we become discouraged, when we begin to doubt, we have the Holy Spirit there as our anchor, as our helper, as our guide, the one who is there to help us run the Christian race. He provides all that we need to make a successful journey as we live in hope. And what is this hope? Believers who put their trust in God, we do have a blessed hope. Our ultimate hope and trust must not be in others or in material possessions, but rather it must be in God. When we come to the end of our pilgrimage here on earth, we cannot take material possessions with us. We cannot take others along with us. We only have God. As the song says, as Deborah ministered, give me Jesus. And that's what her heart's desire was. When she came to the end of her life, her desire, give me Jesus. And he is all that matters. So we must have a hope in God. Trust in him, in his son, Jesus Christ. Trust in the blessed Holy Spirit, our helper, our comforter. What is our hope? Our hope is in God's grace, God's deliverance in the sufferings we must undergo in our present lives. We have hope that the time will come when we will no longer endure the sufferings we now experience on this earth. We have hope of a residence in heaven, for Jesus said, I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am, there you may be also. We have a blessed hope. We have hope of eternal life, the life guaranteed to those who trust and obey the Lord Jesus. We have hope. We have hope in the resurrection, that one day when Jesus returns, the dead in Christ shall rise again. We have a blessed hope of the resurrection. We have hope of seeing Jesus. When he comes for his people, we shall see him and know him even as he is. We have hope of seeing our loved ones again. This is not the end of us seeing Sister Clarissa. It's just for a time, just for a while. But one day, if we live faithful to Jesus, we shall see her again. There's going to be a great reunion in the sky. We have hope of receiving a new body, a body that will not suffer pain, hurt, discomfort, disease, sickness. We have hope of receiving a new body. So we have hope this evening. As the scripture says, the righteous has hope in his death. And when we die as righteous people, we have hope in the resurrection, that one day we shall rise from the dead. We have hope of seeing Jesus. We have hope of seeing our loved ones. And we have hope of receiving a new body. Do you have this hope, even as our sister Clarissa had? You can, by making the right choice to make Jesus your Savior. Living a life of hope begins when you answer the most important question ever asked by anyone. What then? What then shall I do with Jesus, who is called the Christ? Your answer to this question will determine some very important things in your life. If you do the right thing with Jesus, you shall get everything that is worth having, not only for time, but for all eternity. If you do the wrong thing and make the wrong decision by rejecting Jesus, you will lose everything that is worth having for time and for eternity. Our sister Clarissa had to come to that point in her life when she would answer that question. What then shall I do with Jesus, who is called Christ? And thank God, she made the decision to accept Jesus as her Savior. If you do the wrong thing and make the wrong decision, you will lose everything that is worth having for time and for eternity. For as many as received him, to them gave he the power to become the sons of God. Acceptance by God does not depend upon good works or good character, but rather it is dependent on a personal relationship with Jesus. There is nothing in this world to compare with the peace, the joy, and the rest that knowing Jesus gives to us. Peace, joy, and rest. No money can buy those things. But when we put our trust in Jesus and his precious cleansing blood, we receive his peace, we receive his joy, we receive his rest, knowing that when we come to the end of our life to be absent from this body, we are present with the Lord. Having a relationship with Jesus gives us peace of conscience, to know that we can lay our heads on our pillows and say, it is well with my soul. Having a relationship with Jesus gives us joy in the midst of sorrow, in the midst of hurt, in the midst of turmoil and lack. We can have joy. Having a relationship with Jesus guarantees us eternal life and a blessed hope. What then will you do with Jesus? Accept him or reject him? Will you open your heart and let him in, or will you keep him on the outside? The choice is yours. Our sister Clarissa made her choice many years ago, and that determined her eternal destiny, so that today we can have that assurance that she is with her Lord and Savior. How about you? If your pilgrimage journey came to an end before this day is finished, can you say, it is well with my soul? Can you say you have that blessed hope and blessed assurance that you will see your Savior, Jesus? This is the most important thing in life. And as we have come to the celebration and thanksgiving service of our sister, may it be a time when you reflect on your own life to answer the question, what will I do with Jesus, who is called the Christ? Let us pray. If you are here this evening and you do not know Jesus as your Savior, you do not have that assurance, you are not certain that when you pass from life into eternity that you're going to spend eternity with Jesus, if you do not know beyond the shadow of a doubt that it is well with your soul, if you are here this evening and you want to make your calling and election sure, I want you to repeat after me. Heavenly Father, I come to you in the name of your Son, Jesus. Thank you for making a way for me that I can have a relationship with Jesus. I confess that I am a sinner. I need a Savior. I open my heart and I accept you, Jesus, as my Lord and my Savior. Cleanse me, wash me in your precious blood, and make me your child, I pray, in Jesus' precious name. Father, we thank you today that we can open our hearts and receive you and have that assurance that when we pass from this life, we will go to spend eternity with you. Thank you for making a way through your precious blood. And I pray that you will seal these prayers today in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. We're going to ask the family if they will stand at this time as we pray for them. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for the community of the church, and we thank you, Lord, that we have the privilege of standing with this family and supporting them with our prayers. I pray, dear God, today that they will experience your strength and your peace that passeth all understanding. I pray that the memories of their mom, Lord Jesus, of their loved one, will sustain them through the coming days. Pray that you will undergird them with your strength. Pray, God, that your peace that passeth all understanding will garrison every heart, every mind, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for your faithfulness. May they sense that underneath of them are your everlasting arms, supporting and strengthening them. Amen. Amen. And to encourage the rest of the congregation, if you would please stand as we sing the hymn, I Surrender All. All to Jesus, I surrender.
At times like these, we are comforted by the memories of the one we loved. Though we are sad, we do not grieve as those who have no hope. We know that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep in Jesus. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and thus we shall always be with the Lord. 1 Thessalonians 4:14-17. we have shared through these passing years a wonderful companionship and fellowship with our faithful sister, Clarissa. In the name of Jesus Christ, whom she loved and served, we now commit her body to rest, earth to earth, dust to dust, and ashes to ashes, knowing that her spirit is with the Lord in his heavenly house. In so doing, we rest our hearts in fresh confidence upon the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to life through Jesus Christ, who will transform our lowly body, that it may be conformed to his glorious body, according to the working by which he is able even to subdue all things to himself. Let us pray. Father, we gather in this solemn place to remember the life and mourn the death of our loved one, Sister Clarissa. We do not sorrow as those who have no hope, for our hope is in Jesus Christ. We ask that you would comfort each family member and friend. May they be comforted by your word, encouraged through happy memories, and sustained by the hope of the resurrection for all who place their faith in you. Amen. We'd sing the hymn, "Let What a Friend We Have in Jesus." All our sins and griefs to bear.
What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful, who will all our sorrow share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden, cumbered with a load of care? Precious Savior, still our refuge, take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake thee, take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms you'll take and shield.
Thank you. Can it be?
Thank you.
when we all get to heaven.
Wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place. And when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
We'll now have the benediction. Father God, we thank you for this blessed assurance we have that one day we shall be reunited with our sister Clarissa. Help us to know what is most important in this life and to live for you alone. Comfort our grieving hearts and bless the memories of our dear loved one. In the name of Jesus we pray. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you his peace now and forevermore. Amen.
when I am down, and oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, and I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can't stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. Me up to more.